สวัสดีค่ะ Now we come to chapter 4 This is about coordination compounds The objectives are listed here You have to understand the concept of coordination compounds which involve the ligands coordination number oxidation state of the metal and the charge on any complex ion We're gonna learn about this in part one about terminologies. And then second topic, you're gonna have to be able to write formula of this coordination complex and also give name of this coordination compound systematically. After that, we're gonna learn about the different types of isomers which can occur among the coordination compounds. The last topic in this chapter would be about the crystal field theory. We're going to use this theory to explain the bonding within the coordination compounds. The coordination compounds that we will look at in this chapter would have the central metal ion that is part of the transition elements. This is important group of elements because we have quite a number of these elements in the periodic table. We call them transition elements. Down here in this slot here, expanding into this, that are called inner transition elements. The important thing about this element is that they can have more than one oxidation state. The reason is come from the electron configuration of this element. Another characteristic of the transition metal that make them very useful is that because they can have more than one oxidation state and they can create quite a variety of colors. This is the example of coordination compound or this particular one is the complex of transition metal. M in here can be any of these metal. These are the what we will learn later ligand molecules. In this example it is water molecule. Metal ion linked to six water molecules here. If we change the metal, we can see different color. So this is titanium in purple, where manganese give you pink. More than that, if you change the charge of metal ion, look at this vanadium here. 2+ give you purple color. If oxidation number change to 3, it will be in green. 4, it will be in blue. And 5, it will be in yellow. Not only this, if you change the ligand surrounding the metal ion, the color will change as well. So this is why this group of compound is quite important. And in this chapter, we're going to learn about them. Coordination compounds are important because most of elements in the periodic table are metals. And I show you already that most of them are within the transition metals. We use them in many industrial catalysts. And also, they are essential in biochemistry. We found this complex in hemoglobin, which is very important in the body because without it, we will not have anything to transport the oxygen in and out the blood. We see this in cytochrome, which used to transfer electron in the cells in the body. And many of the complex are the component of enzymes, which is quite critical in the biological reactions. Okay, so these are the two examples of coordination compounds that are critical for the good function in our body. I just want to show you the characteristic of the coordination compounds. Both of these two examples have metal ion in the center here. So these are central metal cation, Fe2, cobalt 2. The metal ion link with molecules, link with molecule or small anion like cyanide or some oxygen molecule here. So the molecule or anion here are called ligands. The bond between metal ion and ligand is the coordinate covalent bond. That brings us to the name of this group of substance as coordination compounds. Alright? First thing that we're gonna learn about coordination compound in this chapter, we have to know all the terms, the meaning first. So I start this chapter with terminology. So we're gonna learn about the meaning of coordination compound, the meaning of complex, the meaning of cationic, ligand, donor atom, coordination number, oxidation number. So we can understand when we see a formula of coordination compound like this one. All right, let's start with coordination compound. What is it? It is a substance that typically contains at least one complex ion or neutral complex species. So I give you one example already. On this slide, I put two examples of coordination compounds. The first one has neutral complex. So this group within this bracket, square bracket here, identify complex. The second example, this is coordination compound that has complex ion. So this group here within this square bracket again is the complex ion. So these two are coordination compound because it has at least one complex, either neutral or as ion. Next, what is then the meaning of complex? Complex consists of central metal cation bonded to ligands by coordinate covalent bond. So identify within the complex here, what is metal ion, what is ligand? All right, in red, these are metal cation. We will identify the charge on these metals later, นะคะ. These are metal cation. In green, are ligands. So, complex consists of central metal cation bonded to ligands by coordinate covalent bond. So this platinum is linked to ammonia molecule and chloride ion by coordinate covalent bond. This cobalt is also linked to this ammonia molecule by coordinate covalent bond. Okay, next what we have to look at, we haven't talked about this one yet. So this outside the square bracket or outside the complex is called cationic ion. Counter ions are needed to maintain electrical neutrality in the compound. So if you have coordination compound that consists of neutral complex, you don't need counter ion. But if you have coordination compound that consists of complex ion, you're gonna need counter ion to make sure that it cancels the charge of the ion to make the whole compound neutral. So we, from this example, we know exactly the bracket show the complex. Outside bracket is the counter ion. And you see from these two examples that you have at least one species Cl or chloride ion here. One example, it is ligand. Another example, it is counter ion. The question is, how do we know that we should put chloride ion inside the bracket to be ligand or outside the bracket to be counter ion? The reason for this formula occur after the study of Alfred Werner, and he suggested Werner's coordination theory. What he did, he studied many compounds by looking at number of ions in solution and the precipitation of halide. So for example, this group of compounds look very, very similar. You have one platinum, four chloride ion, and some molecules of ammonia. The first one you have 6, the second one you have 5, the third one you have 4 ammonia. So he thought that if the platinum ion are bond to all 4 chloride ion by ionic bonding, if we put this compound in the solution, there must be a total of 5 ions in solution, which are one of the platinum ion and 4 of the chloride ion. All right. And if we try to see how many chloride ion would be precipitated by adding the silver ion, all 4 chloride ion must be precipitated. The result that he found are like this. The first one, when he count the number of ions in solution, he found that he has 5 ions per formula unit. The second one is 4. The third one is 3. We are not talking about how he did the experiment. Looking at the result here, the first formula gives the total of ion as 5, where the second gives total of ion as 4, the third gives the total of ion as 3. Moreover, when he precipitated the chloride ion by silver ion, he found that the number of chloride ion that are precipitated in the 3 compounds are different. The first is 4. The second is 3, the third is 2. Okay, so from this result, he then suggests that only this number of chloride ion are linked to the platinum by ionic bonding. So when we put this in the solution, this chloride ion will be separated and then can be precipitated by silver ion. So here are the chloride ion that can be precipitated, 4, 3, and 2. Then he put everything else in the formula inside the bracket and call this complex. So in the first one, all 4 chloride ion are precipitated, so they are outside the complex. Second one, 3 of them outside the complex, but one would be inside the complex. The last one, 2 be outside, 2 be inside. And the chloride ion that are inside the complex will not be separated in the solution. So he suggested then the link between this chloride ion with platinum in the bracket is not ionic bonding. It is covalent bonding. The next slide, we will see how the complex or the bond in the complex are formed. The bond inside the complex, this is your complex. Silver ion as metal ion, ammonia molecule as ligand. This ammonia molecule has lone pair on nitrogen atom. The reaction or the bond between these two species occur by coordinate covalent bond. Nitrogen here use these two electrons to form bond with silver ion. The bond is occurred by sharing of electron, and this is the covalent bond. The sharing of electron, which the two electrons come from one atom only, is called a coordinate covalent bond. We learned this from the semester one, okay? So here is the formation of bond inside the complex. Inside the complex, the bond between metal ion and molecules or anion occur as covalent bond, which is why we will not separate them into ion anymore. Further than that, from chapter 2, we learn about acid base definition. This bonding between metal ion and ligand can be recognized as Lewis acid base reaction. The silver ion or metal ion is considered a Lewis acid because it receives or accepts electron pair. Metal ion is Lewis acid, or the electron pair acceptor, where ligand or ammonia molecule in this example give electron pair, so it is recognized as Lewis base. So formation of complex is a Lewis acid base reaction. The bonding occur as coordinate covalent bond. We look into ligand in more detail. Ligand, by definition, are molecules or ions that have electrons to give to metal cation. Ligands are Lewis base. Lewis base give electron pair. So anything that can be ligands will have to be able to give electron pairs away. So molecules like ammonia that has lone pair electron to give away can be ligand. Ions that has, especially the anion that has extra electron and then can use two electron to make bond, can be ligand. This slide show you in more detail the specific point of atom that is linked to the metal. If you have just one ion like this, one atom ion like chloride ion here, this is the point this atom is linked to the metal ion, so it's no question. But if we have ligand like this one ammonia, we have more than one atom in the molecule, we have to specify which atom exactly that is linked to the metal. In this example, ammonia molecule, when we draw Lewis structure, you get this structure. The nitrogen has lone pair electron. So this is the point where it is linked to the metal. And this is given a name as donor atom. The atom that give electron pair to bond with metal through coordinate covalent bond. Okay, we came up to the definition of coordination number. When we look at the coordination compound, how many bonds are occur between metal ion and ligands? That is called the coordination number. So say it again, the coordination number of metal ion in a complex is the number of bonds formed between metal ions to ligands in the complex ion or neutral complex. Many metal ions show more than one coordination number. So there is no simple way to predict what it will be in particular case. So for example, if you see cobalt ion, it's not easy to predict that how many bond can it form to the ligand. The coordination number varies depend on the size, the charge, and electron configuration of the metal ion itself. So it cannot be predicted very easily. However, the common coordination number are 2, 4, and 6. And in this class, we're going to focus on this 2, 4, and 6 coordination number only. Look at this text. You may not be able to visualize. See this, นะคะ? Coordination number is the number of bonds formed between metal ion to ligand. So look at picture here. I give you three examples. These are coordination compound, complex ion, complex ion. All right. This is the metal ion cobalt. The bond occur from this point. It's called as one bond, two bond, three bonds, four, five, and six. Therefore, the coordination number is equal to 6. Look at the second example, central metal ion cobalt again. From this point, how many bonds occur? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So the coordination number is also 6. Last one, M, is the metal ion. In this picture, it used the red dotted line to show the bond between metal ion to this molecule. Metal ion here. So how many bonds around it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So coordination number is also 6. These three examples has the same coordination number of metal ion. Okay. Look at the formula. We identify metal ion, okay, metal ion cobalt, and M. Can you identify ligands? Ligands are inside the complex. So in the first one, ammonia molecule is ligand. How many of them? 6. In the second example, this is the bracket. So this one, EN, is ligand. Don't worry about what is it just yet. En linked to metal ion, so it's a ligand. How many of them? Two. Chloride ion is also ligand. How many of them? Two. So you have four ligands. But coordination number is 6. You have 6 ligands. Coordination number is also 6. So what is the difference here? Last one, you only have one ligand, EDTA, one ligand. But coordination number is 6. So from this example, you may think, what is the difference? One thing that you can see clearly that coordination number is not the number of ligand in complex. It is not the number of ligand in complex. It is the number of bonds. So you have to count bonds. All right? And you can see that some ligand make one bond to metal ion like ammonia. So if you have 6, it creates 6 bond. Some ligand, you have 1, but you make 6 bond. So some ligand can make more than 1 bond. Okay, some ligand can make more than 1 bond. This makes 6. Another ligand like this one, En. This is En. It make 2 bonds. 2 ligand. So you have 2, it make 4 bond, 1, 2, 3, 4. Chlorion, you have 2, each of these make 1 bond, 2 ion. So from this slide, we can then see that ligand can be identified into different types, and it's called according to the number of bond that it can make to metal ion as monodentate, bidentate, or polydentate ligand. Mono means 1. So monodentate ligand, another name you can call it unidentate ligand. Unit also means 1. Monodentate form 1 bond to metal ion. Bidentate form 2 bonds to metal ion. Polydentate for many bonds to metal ion. So in this example, ammonia is a monodentate ligand. Chloride ion is a monodentate ligand, where En is a bidentate ligand. EDTA is a polydentate ligand. Okay? There are so many ligands out there. So many of them. Small one, anion like this, a very big one like this, or you see from heme or vitamin B12 earlier, ligand can be a very big structure molecule. Okay, but in this course, you must know at least this monodentate ligands. You can have monodentate ligand like as neutral molecules, or you can have monodentate ligand as anion. Okay, these are the formula of this molecule ligand. These are the formula of the anion. Okay, we will come back to this slide later when you learn about name nomenclature of coordination compound. นะคะ and some of the example of bidentate ligands in this class I am asking you to remember this one bidentate ligand the name is ethylene diamine in short you saw this several times now En come from ethylene diamine En, ethylene diamine. This one molecule has 2 donor atoms, this hydrogen and this nitrogen. There are two donor atoms, so one molecule of En can form two bonds to metal ion. Other bidentate ligand that shown here is the glycinate ion, oxalate ion. But I ask you, you must recognize this, นะคะ And the polydentate ligand, I give you just one example, EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetate ion. One EDTA has 6 points where can be bond to ion. Okay. Furthermore, the term that are not on the list but you should know about is the chelate. This is pronounced chelate. This word mean the claw, like the crab claw, like this. Imagine the crab when it kind of grab on your finger, it doesn't want to let go, right? So same thing here. If you have ligand that can make two or more bonds to metal ion, this kind of compound is called chelate type of compound, because the ligand make at least 2 points, grab the metal ion by 2 points, so it look like the crab claw grab onto your finger. Okay, the ligand that can make chelate are called chelants or chelators or chelating agents. When you look at the complex ion like this one, cobalt, linked to 3 of the ethylene diamine, the structure of the ethylene diamine is quite complex here. If you show every atom, it can be very difficult to draw and look at. So in this chapter, in many textbooks, when we draw the structure of complex ion like this, you're gonna just put the donor atom surrounding metal, and then use this kind of link to represent all the rest of the molecule. Okay, so this must go together, so it look like the claw, same thing here for EDTA. This that I just put the mouse around it, it's just one EDTA, but it take on the metal ion by 6 point. So it's like the hand that grab onto what something. You put all your finger onto something, so it grab on very strong. Very strong. So the chelate or compound like this will be very stable because the ligand grab onto the ion very strongly. Okay, I want you to know this because this group of compound are quite important. I show you some example here. They use a lot in the food supplements. Some of them I took the picture. Zinc chelate, chromium chelate, magnesium chelate, iron chelate. These are the chelated minerals. Chelated minerals. The mineral, you know that we need zinc ion to in our body to zinc ion it is essential for the nail and the hair. If you want a healthy looking hair, you should take enough zinc ion. All right. So chelated minerals are designed to enhance the absorption of this mineral in your body. Okay, we are not looking at what kind of chelants they use here, but this is one of the big industry. The food supplement is a big industry because everyone want to be healthy. Okay. Another application about the chelate is in the chelation therapy. Chelation therapy. For example, this is the flow of the blood inside the artery, for example. Sometimes we have too many poison in the bloodstream. Too many poison from the heavy metal in the bloodstream. So the flow of the blood is not very nice, and this can give the illness. And the doctor may use the chelation therapy, give you some EDTA in your bloodstream. The EDTA is then grab onto this heavy metal ion and push it out from your blood. Later, you're gonna have a very clean artery, so the flow of the blood will be nicer. So these are just two example of application of this term chelate or chelation. Okay, come back to our terminology. The last one, the oxidation number. The oxidation number or oxidation state is the charge of the metal ion. The charge of metal ion. The charge of metal ion and the total charge of ligands determine the charge of complex. Alright, so these two examples. Before we learn about coordination number, these two examples has the same coordination number as 6. When we look at the oxidation number of metal ion, what is the charge on this cobalt? What is the charge on this cobalt? The answer is +3 and +3. Okay, how do we get oxidation number of cobalt ion here? I said that the charge of metal ion and ligand make the charge of complex. Okay, this is the coordination compound that has the complex ion and counter ion. So when we separate the compound to be cation, this is the part of cation, this is the part of anion. Okay, how do I know that this is chloride minus 1? This is the basic knowledge from properties of element in periodic table. Chlorine atom is part of the group 7A, so it has only one type of charge, and that is minus 1. So we have 3 of this, so we have 3 of the chloride minus 1 ion. Right? This is neutral, so when you have 3 negative charge, this is 1 complex, so it must have 3 positive charge. Alright? We focus on the complex. We have cobalt, we want to know the charge. And we have 6 of the ammonia molecule. Ammonia molecule is neutral, so the charge is 0. 6 times 0 makes 0. Alright, so x plus 0 must be equal to plus 3 here. 6, x plus 0 equal to +3. So x is +3. This is the cobalt 3+. This is the oxidation number. How about the next example? This is the complex ion already. You know exactly what is the charge of this complex ion. In this complex ion, we have cobalt. We have two of ethylene diamine, and we have two of the chloride ion. Ethylene diamine is a neutral molecule again, so this makes zero. Chloride ion, two of them make negative two. So add this all together make plus one. Do simple calculation, it gets X as plus three. So this is cobalt 3+. This is the oxidation number. All right? It's not so complicated to find out, นะคะ. So right now, we learn everything in terms of terminology of the coordination compound. If I ask you to identify the compound into the items like this one, this is the compound. What is complex? What is complex? So you take everything inside this square bracket. Okay. What is the oxidation number? Oxidation number. Look at the metal ion. Okay. This is zero. This is negative two. Make zero charge of the complex. So platinum must have two positive charge. What is coordination number? You count number of bonds between ligand and metal ion. These are monodentate ligands. So you have four of them. So it makes four bonds. Coordination number is four. This one does not have counter ion. What are ligands? So you answer ammonia and chloride ion. You have two of ammonia. You have two of chloride ion. Don't answer me that ligand is Cl2. Cl2 is not ligand. Uh-huh. It doesn't have a free electrons to give away. All right. The next example. This is the compound. This is the compound. This time you have complex ion as a negative charge ion. Cobalt. Cl4 2 negative. How do you know that this is 2 negative? Because you have ammonium ion. Ammonium ion has plus 1 charge. How do I know this, Ajahn? You learn about this since semester 1. This is the polyatomic ion that you must memorize the formula, the charge of them. So ammonium ion has plus 1 charge. You have 2 of them, so it makes 2 positive charge and balanced by 1 complex ion that must have a 2 negative charge here. What is the oxidation number? The oxidation number, looking at this cobalt, you have chloride ion, 4 of them, so that make negative 4 plus X equal to negative 2. So cobalt must have positive 2 charge. Coordination number, this is the monodentate ligand. You have four of them, so coordination number is four. What is the counter ion? The ammonium ion. How many of them? Two. What is ligand? You have just one type ligand here, chloride ion. You have four of them. Okay? How about this? Can you recognize the complex in this compound? What is the oxidation number of metal ion? What is the coordination number? Do you have counter ion? And what is ligand? How about this one? What is complex? What is counter ion? And what is ligand? You can pause the video and come back when you are done to check the answer, นะคะ? These are the answer card. Do you get it right? I hope everyone get it right. Okay, this is for terminology. The next topic will be about the nomenclature. So I see you again next video ค่ะ สวัสดีค่ะ